One of our lifelong goals here at PPI have always been to introduce primates to naturalistic habitats. And it was always a dream of ours to actually see spider monkeys in the trees and actually really enjoying a slice of like nature, the way nature really intended them to live. Our spider monkeys previously lived in this very large, long habitat. It was about 100 feet long, gives them a lot of space to brachiate, and it, from there had two tunnelways that connected to corn cribs. The thing that I always appreciated and liked about those types of habitats is you have the animals in a really nice space. You can do a lot with that habitat. You can add boards, you can add ropes, you can change the foundation, you can add rocks, you can sanitize the habitat very, very thoroughly if you need be, and it's a very secure habitat. And it's a home where basically every morning when I wake up, I can go to that habitat, walk around the corn crib, and I can see whoever's in that habitat. And they're no more than 10 or 15 feet tops away from you. You can really provide good observations, good health care. You can get to the animals if need be. What we're doing right now as the first stage of the spider monkey introduction to this natural habitat is we've introduced the two males into this habitat. There's my boy, who's a very large black one. And there's also WC, who's more of a Central American spider monkey. He has a lighter coat. These are expats that were acquired by a woman who basically had like 7 or 8, and when she could no longer maintain the whole population, she asked us to take them in. This habitat is basically 40 feet high, it's 40 feet wide, it's 40 feet long. It was designed on somewhat of a hill, so there's a slope to it. It has a huge natural live oak tree that basically dominates the majority of the habitat. They're kind of coming up to us at times, asking for a little bit of comfort because, you know, they're in a huge environment. They've never been in anything this big or this natural. So they're actually running up to us going like, how you doing, you know? I've seen them doing a lot of scent marking. They're like scent marking the dirt and scent marking tree branches. Little WC, I'm so paranoid about right now is, you know, I see him grabbing tree branches that are like real flexible. And I know these guys have never been on like trees before. And he's just sitting there just kind of swinging up and down on these tree branches. And I'm thinking, oh, he's gonna fall. He's gonna fall. He's gonna fall. And he's just absolutely having a blast just playing on tree branches. Working with a 40-foot tall habitat like this and a 40-foot long habitat, I mean, it's harder to do observations. Even though this is a great habitat for the primates, this type of habitat requires a lot of work on the part of the employees. They have to spend a lot of time doing observations. You really have to sit here and know your animals. You have to work with the keepers and make sure that they have a really clear identity of who the animals are, they can spot the individuals, and that they can spot individual variations, like, you know, if one is not eating well, if one doesn't look right, if one might have a bite or might have an injury. It is natural for them to, and instinctive for them to hide their injuries. So they're not gonna come up to you and go like, look, I have a boo-boo or I have an injury. They don't do this, they hide from you. So basically all you had to do was hide away for 2-3 days long enough to keep away from you. They develop an infection and now you have to treat them for the infection. And I hope that with my staff, we continue to develop our observation skills and we continue to develop our relationships with our primates. Like this one in particular, this is my boy. And you know, it's great when you have a little ex-pet like my boy that kind of will come down to you and you can spend the time looking at him. I mean, this is great. I wish they all did this, but they don't. We get a lot of ex-research animals that don't want anything to do with us, and they'll sit at the opposite end of this habitat, and you'll never get a chance to really do close observations unless you capture them or get them in a lockdown. People who work at an animal sanctuary, an animal shelter, or a rehabilitation center, they really need to learn from their successes, and they really need to learn from their failures. As long as that is the goal of a sanctuary, is to learn and provide better care to the animals who are being rescued, who are being sent to them, then that's a good sanctuary, a sanctuary that is continually trying to improve itself and provide better care to the animals. And I think, you know, Primarily Primates, over the last 2 years, we've done a great job. We've had amazing successes here. I want to make sure that they're having fun. I mean, I want to make sure that they have really enriched lives. So seeing them really enjoy this habitat is great, and I can't wait to get the rest of the females. There's five more females that are going to go into this habitat. This is a great accomplishment for Primarily Primates.